At this saying, his countenance fell, and he went away sorrowful, for he had great possessions. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated. This period of time from in October, November, it is almost as if the framers of the lectionary put gospels that talk about money on the calendar so Episcopal churches could talk about money. I don't think they did it on purpose, but you know what? They may have. And it's always a strange subject, because even if we look at how Jesus talked about money, he almost seemed bipolar on the subject. On the one hand, it was the poor that he seemed to favor, wasn't it? It was to the poor that he went continually. And yet, in today's gospel, he looks on the rich man and said, he looked on him and he loved him. And said, you lack but one thing, having done these. He didn't name all the 10. He was, for sake of brevity, compiled them into a few. He said, I've done all these from my birth, all these commandments. You lack one thing, which is to sell all you have and give it to the poor. But he looked on the rich man and loved him. Our Lord loves all, and he asks all of all. That's the key here. Now, our Lord talks about money all the time. It's either business or money. It's talking about fishing to fishermen. It's talking about vineyard maintenance amongst people who work in vineyards. It's talking about tax collection with those who collect taxes and with those who pay them. Well, we drink wine and we buy groceries and we pay taxes. And sometimes we go to Florida for 6 months and a day to try to minimize such things. I don't know if any of you do that. I'm just throwing that out as something that some people do, because it's required that we render unto Caesar that which is Caesar, and that to God that which is God's. But it's a crime to render unto Caesar a penny more than he requires, I would say, because then you don't have enough left over to give to God, because God wants a lot. Please, sir, come in. All are welcome at all times, and find a seat. There's a little leaflet there that you can pick up and join us. We are told by Jesus, on the one hand, sell all that you have. What is he really getting at here? What is he really getting at? I want to bring you back to a little over a year ago, when you were stuck in your room or the confines of your house because of COVID. I was more or less in one room all day long, and life was simple. We couldn't buy things because we were afraid to go to the grocery store. We couldn't go out and see our friends because we were afraid they were going to make us sick and we were going to die. You were all in the same situation, whatever your context was. Life became simpler, and what was important to us became clear. For me, it was my prayer book, my wife, my dog, my cat, and my world became very small. And then very quickly, I discovered that my world could become bigger through Zoom and using the telephone and all of a sudden, my world became much bigger. But that period of clarification was important. I experienced the same thing when I go on retreat to a monastery. And I realize that living a very simple life, or when I'm on a vacation and life is reduced to, what am I going to eat today? And where am I going to go? And how am I going to pass the time? And this simplification is clarifying, because it helps us to realize what is important. What is important are the people we love. What is important is the God we worship, the one who created us, the one who redeemed us, and the one who sustains us in the midst of all the trials and tribulations of the lives we lead. But where does that leave all the stuff we accumulate? I heard it expressed this way by a rector that I really loved growing up, who had a way with words. He said it this way about riches, he said, and possessions. He said, my brothers and sisters, at best in this world, we rent. We came into this world naked, and we'll leave it naked. We can't take it with you, and you will have nothing when you leave. Jesus makes this very strange analogy in today's gospel. It is easier for a camel to pass through the eye of a needle than it is for a rich man to get into the kingdom of heaven, which I'm sure you know this analysis, but if you don't, I'll tell you. And if you've heard it before, I'll repeat it. I always thought, had this image of this large, goofy looking four-legged beast of burden trying to get in through a sewing needle that I can't even fit a thread through. Now that's an image that just seems hyperbolic and ridiculous. Until my seventh grade Bible and theology teacher at school explained the real context of it. Jesus was talking to people who knew the city of Jerusalem, and there was a gate through which merchants bearing goods on camel would come. And it was called the Eye of the Needle because it was a narrow gate. And in order to get the camel through, you had to take the goods off of a camel to get them through. It was part of the customs process. That way they could be sure you'd taken everything off, paid the duty. Then you get the camel through and you put it back on the other side. He was making an image, which was this. We have to unburden ourselves of the love of possessions, because money is not the root of all evil, often misquoted. The love of money is the root of all evil. Money is but a tool. It's a tool that in this church we need to provide ministry and further the mission of God in this place and to the people of Old Greenwich and beyond. It is merely a tool which we encourage you to share of your tools and your talent and your treasure with this congregation as we, in with you and for you and to you, seek to further that ministry and God's mission. More on that from Bruce and our treasurer and our treasurer designate going forward. But today, I just invite you to think about the stuff you have. And if you find yourself liking your car a whole lot, re-examine your relationship with your car. If you find yourself really loving your house, re-examine your relationship with your house. The object of our love should be God and should be people. And so I invite you to unburden yourself like the camel at the gate of the eye of the needle and pass through it into eternal life, which can begin right now. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.